Hello everyone, and welcome to another video, and welcome to my truck, which is a Ford F-150 XLT. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you all the exterior, the interiors, and also we'll be going on a short drive. So starting off with the front, this particular color is the Oxford white color, and then in the center you would find this big blacked out grille with the huge Ford logo in the middle and these two thick bars, and really makes it look very muscular. You know, at the bottom you would find these two towing hooks and some more, you know, plastic bits here and there. And these headlamps are halogen headlamps, completely the entire cluster, and also the halogen fog lamps. At the bottom you would find this plate, which is made out of plastic so that it's easier to replace. On the sides, you can see this truck is pretty long, even though it's just a two-door, but let me walk you through. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It's literally 6 steps. That is, so it's that long. You get 20-inch aluminum cut rims along with this black design, and then these tires are all-terrain tires. You get this F-150 XLT badging on the side, and then a sideboard which is fixed, so there is no mechanical bits, like, you know, which folds inside and perfect. So this is a non-power foldable mirror, so it is foldable manually, so you can do that. And then there are lights around on the mirror, so at night you can illuminate the ground, and also there is a light on the side, so you can illuminate basically your surroundings if you are in a darker place. So on the door you would see this design which curves at the bottom, which is a famous 150 style, so that is particularly to increase the visibility while you are driving or for the passenger, so that they can see from the side mirrors, these big side mirrors. And then this very famous keypad, so if you are ever locked out of your Ford, you can just input like a pin just like your phone, and then you can open your car. How cool. There is also an additional board which is retractable, which is hydraulically retractable, so all you have to do is press this button out here, and then you can pull it out, and then when you are done with it you can put it back. You get just the normal door handles and a big truck bed in the back, and there is a lot of suspension travel. In fact, there is an arch on the sides which you can see, so that's pretty much this much of travel. I mean, so on the back you get F-150, which is indented on the body surface, and then this Ford logo. But again, I apologize for it being a little dirty because it's super windy. I haven't even taken this car into the desert, by the way. It's just the sand which is blowing, and it's just sort of dirtied the whole car. So there is also a power outlet for your trailer, so you can connect all the different lines. I mean, I don't know, there's already a pickup, but you still need a trailer, so you can connect that. And then there are more points at the bottom, and you get the parking sensors too on the side. And then there is another big hook with which you can connect your additional caravan or anything which you have using at the bottom. And the exhaust tips are on the side, so it's a single tip exhaust which is chromed, so it's on the right side of the car. And then you have this big tailgate. Now that tailgate, when you open it, just falls directly, so be careful when you are opening that. So it's not a hydraulically or electronically controlled tailgate. So big huge space in the back, again Ford badging in the back. And then there is also the boot loading light, and also there are additional LED lights inside the at the back side. So in terms of the boot space, you get approximately 1590 liters of space in the back. And then there is also this this button which you press, and then you can remove the stair, which you can, you know, if you are someone who wants to climb in the back of the truck. And also there is this handle that comes out, so you can just use and then get inside. Also, you can see there is a big glass in the back, so the rear visibility is pretty clear in this car. Now on the inside, this F-150 XLT is super huge, even though it's a two-seater, and also there is a third seat which is why you see there is no armrest, but there is an armrest. I'm going to be coming to that. But yes, this is a super spacious car. And starting off with the dashboard screen, now the dashboard screen is pretty simple. You know, you have your dials on both the sides, and then there is a 4.4-inch display which can show you different details like your trip information, like you know, your trailer information, how much load are you pulling, and also various other fuel economy and stuff. All of that can be displayed on that screen itself, and also your warnings and also the cruise control information. Every single thing can be displayed on that. Now the steering wheel is manually adjustable, which is telescopic and tilt, and also it's pretty huge and chunky. You have on your right side the infotainment controls, and on your left side you have the cruise control, and also the controls to change all the various displays on the multi-information display. The material quality is pretty good, like everywhere, wherever you see, like on the door cards, you would see on the dashboard, everything is like nice sort of plastics which they have used. And also there's this cool way of opening the door. You know, usually you have the handles which you just pull. The seats are fabric seats, and the driver seat is sort of semi-automatic, so a few features, but it's 8-way adjustable, so a few features are controlled using the electronic button, and the adjustment of the backrest is manually controllable. The passenger seat is manually adjustable. Now you would see there is no center console in where I am sitting, so this is like a third seat which you can use. Also there is like a transmission tunnel which goes, but it's not big, so you know, someone can to comfortably sit in the center also. So again, if you want to make this like an armrest, you can press this button out here and the center seat falls down, and now you have two cup holders and ample of storage also. So this is like a two-in-one, where it's like a three-seater, but whenever you are just two people and you want to use all the, you know, cup holders and all of that, so this has been cleverly, you know, made to do that. There's also this phone stand, like a flat thing where you can just, you know, put your phones. Otherwise, in terms of storage, there is some amount of storage in the door cards, and there is huge storage like this glove box, and also there is another storage on top of the dashboard. This is where you can put a lot of stuff, but otherwise this is pretty much it in terms of storage. You can put a liter of bottle in the door cards, and there are also these smaller storages, I don't know, where you can put your pen or something, maybe something very small, like, you know, the key or something, so you can do that. But there is no sunroof in this car, and the visibility, as I mentioned, is superb, like, you know, all around, like big windows, and then this rear glass, and this rear glass is auto dimming. The air conditioning controls are super simple, and everything is button, so superb. The buttons are all laid out so clearly, like, you know, for every function there is a button. Like if I want to change the flow of air, there is a button for that. There is no, like, you know, pressing it 2-3 times to eventually reach to that option. So straightforward. There are dials on both the sides, so it's, there is no dual zone, but the normal AC controls. The infotainment system is an 8.8-inch touch capacitive screen, so that is pretty clear during the day, and it's got a wide amount of features where you know, you can just directly see the compass. You can also connect your phone, but also there are mobile apps where you know, you can connect it using the Bluetooth, and also there is various settings where you can change the clock, you know, you can go to the Wi-Fi. You can also set up like a Wi-Fi which can be used by the passengers inside the car. There is also that feature. So there are also automatic updates in case you connect your phone and it would use the phone data to connect and, you know, update the car. Also there is also Android Auto, there is also Apple CarPlay, there is also various vehicle display where you can change the camera settings, the password for the door which I mentioned before. There's also display settings where you can change the theme and the color of the background on your screen. There's also voice control. There is also something called as a valet mode. In the valet mode, you can lock all the features of the car using a 4-digit pin, so that whenever you give it for, you know, the valet services, then you can come back and whenever you pick up the car, you can enter those 4 digits and then, you know, activate all the functions. That's pretty clever. There's also traction control button on the top. There is also an engine cutoff feature, which like the engine start and stop feature button, which has have been given out here. And then there is this dial out here with which you can change the two-wheel drive, the four-wheel drive. So there is two high, four high, and four low. So the three simple modes, and then you can straight, you know, change it using this dial. But otherwise it's a pretty simple, easy to use car. Now in terms of connectivity or charging points, you would get one power socket at the bottom. There is another 12 volt 120 watt power socket on the sides, and then there are two USB ports with which you can connect either your phone or also you can charge it. There are big grab handles out here and also big sun visors. That is a very important feature, and that is right out here. Even when you put it on the sides, they pretty much cover all the way till the back. And it's also, whenever it's in the front, it's pretty, you know, huge. So I had mentioned about the boot lights and also the side lights which you can operate. So those buttons are given on the left side of the driver, so you can press those buttons, and then you know you can control individual lights whichever you want. So powering this F-150 XLT is a 5 liter V8 non-turbocharged petrol engine that produces 394 brake horsepower and 555 newton meters of torque. Now naturally aspirated engine, but yet it's got so much of torque, and it's a pretty responsive engine, let me tell you that. Like it's got that grunt, you know, the raw V8 grunt. Like for example, like this, see, like it takes a little bit, like there's slight, you know, half a second delay before it starts reacting, but it's fine. Like, you know, the moment it picks up, you don't realize that, you know, such a big truck. Like this is a 2.9 ton truck, pickup truck, and you don't realize how quickly you start moving the moment you press the accelerator. But otherwise the power delivery is pretty smooth. But it all is also to do with the fact that this has, the engine is mated to a 10 speed select shift gearbox, automatic gearbox, and the gear shifts, I mean 10 gears, but then all of them shift so well. Like, you know, you don't realize that, you know, you are shifting through 10 gears. But there's also this thing that, you know, when you're trying to go at constant speed, there are certain variations in the gear changes that the car keeps doing. You know, sometimes it's just confused between the 5th, 6th, 7th gears, and then it's just trying to get the right, you know, gear. The moment I press a little bit of throttle, it just wants to go, you know, change it to another gear or something. But then that's the only thing. But otherwise, it's a very smooth sort of gear changes. So if you want to go from the parking to the dry mode, then this is like a cool stick out here instead of, you know, the usual dials or a stick at the normal center console, which is why it gets so much space in the center console, because they have converted the gear shifter and put it out here in the dashboard itself. So you just have to just, you know, sort of change the gears like this. It gets a little used to, but then it's a fun way to do, you know, it's a very different way. But coming to the steering wheel, now the steering wheel is pretty light. You can't really feel the weight of the car from the steering wheel, although you get quite a bit of input from the steering wheel, where, you know, the bumps and everything. And also it's pretty pointy, and the suspension is on the harder side, and also the roll on this car is super low. Like, you know, when I am trying to turn, look at this. Like there is literally no roll in the car. Like, and that's pretty amazing that, you know, a car this big and they managed to do that. But then also there is the bed, which is sometimes, you know, when there is no load on it, what happens is that it tries to flex itself, because there is no, it's literally like an overhang, and all the bumps you can literally feel from the chassis, you know, passing through and into the seat, and then you eventually feel it. But there is a lot of, if you put quite a bit of load, or even fair bit of load, I would say, if you put that in the boot, then, you know, the flexing sort of goes down, and also it becomes more sort of comfortable, you know, with the ride. So the F-150 comes with a four-wheel drive system. There is an electronic differential for the rear axle, and that has a ratio of 3.73. Also, in terms of the modes, you get a sport mode, and also there is a tow and a haul mode. So you can switch on to that, and the car will know that, you know, you are trying to tow something, and it would change the settings accordingly. But it is pretty easy to use car, you know, every day, like, you know, just jump in and everything is simple and sorted. Everything has a button to it so that you can find your way, and it is super huge. I mean, this camera is literally like so far away from me, it's pretty unusual, because usually I have it at my tips, like, you know, I can just press it and then switch it off. But this is like way far, and I feel like it's literally like miles away from me. Now, coming to the brakes, so the brakes are, it's so essential that, because I keep mentioning the fact that, you know, a car this big has so much of momentum, and the big brakes make sure that they stop you whenever you want to. The brake pedal is pretty accurate. Now, overall, the NVH levels in this car are extremely well, because this build quality is so good, and which is why you don't feel any amount of wind whooshing or anything inside the car, because there is no sunroof. Also, why you get better NVH levels. Now, in terms of the safety systems, you would get 6 airbags, 2 in the driver and the passenger, and 2 side airbags, 2 curtain airbags. I mean, I know it's just a 2-seater pickup, but then it has 6 airbags. There is tire pressure monitoring system, there is hill hold assist, there is also traction control, there is also the camera system, which is a single camera system. The output from that is pretty all right and I am satisfied, but it's again to do because it's a capacitive screen, so the output is going to be very limited, but still it's pretty crisp and clear, I would say. There is also roll stability control, there is also curve control, so there are lots of control systems which make sure that the car is stable, you know, at every point of time, or if you go off-roading, then, you know, these are all the stability stuff that keeps happening inside the car while you keep driving it. There is also an SOS alert system, which is like the post accident, it would send like an alert to the relevant authorities around you to make sure that, you know, it informs and calls and medical help immediately. Now, if you ask me, this pickup truck is a built to last everyday rugged one, because the materials are built to last. It's got the supreme build quality. The dynamics, the driving dynamics are pretty good for a pickup truck, and also it's that way is very easier to use, you know, jump in and then you are just, you don't have to go around a lot of electronic stuff. And also the pickup that way is small because it's got 2 less doors and 1 bench less of a rear seat, so which is why it's a smaller pickup also, and so it's easier to navigate also, because I've literally had like this truck for just one day and I have, you know, just got in and understood every single thing. So I mean, yeah, for that reason I would say this is a very, you know, viable one as an option if you are looking for a pickup truck with just 2 people. So anyways, give it a thumbs up if you've liked this video, and if you want to subscribe to my channel, then click here, and if you want to watch more videos, then click here. I shall see you in the next video. Bye bye and take care.